My name is Abby Everingham. I am a realtor in Calgary, Alberta. I'm coming up at you with episode number 2 of my real estate investing podcast. And today we are going to talk about Airbnbs and really deep dive into someone's business who manages 40 Airbnbs around Calgary. So they're very educated when it comes to any sort of problems in building a business in the Airbnb scene. Last episode, I talked about interest rates rising and what that will have as an effect on the market. And just to further expand on that, right now would be an amazing time to invest because with those interest rates that have risen, it is harder for people to pass the stress test when getting approved. So it's leveling out the amount of people that can qualify for a house. So resulting in houses dropping their prices, staying on the market longer, and less competition when it comes to making offers. This is the time when you can usually get the best deals. If you look at the history of houses and prices and investment properties, having those high interest rates are scaring people off, especially for these next coming weeks. With them recently have risen. This is when we're gonna see the biggest slowdown within these coming weeks. So that's the time when you're probably gonna get the best deals. Hello everybody, today I am here with Reese. He is an Airbnb expertise, manages around 40 in Calgary, and is the guy you're gonna wanna have a conversation with if you are interested in Airbnbs. Okay, tell me a little bit about yourself, Reese. How do you get into the industry?
I guess back in 2018, I was doing digital marketing for local companies here in Calgary. And then I saw a few people in the city kind of doing Airbnb. And I had one property with my now business partner that we owned together in Sunnyside over in Kensington. We had lived in it and then we were renting it out to long-term renters. And we had a month-to-month tenant in it at the time. And I kind of saw it as an opportunity to post it at kind of a ridiculous price. If it got rented out, then it would make sense to get the current month-to-month renters out of there and kind of pursue it. And so it was May of 2019, or end of April, I believe, that I posted it. And then the first booking came in. It was 47 nights, and I think the nightly rate that we had put it up for was $500 a night. And then
47 nights?
Yeah, it was 40.
Holy shit, that was the first booking you had?
Yeah, very first booking. Didn't really know what we were doing. I kind of told Mateo about it, who's my now business partner, saying, oh, I should post it up on here. And we weren't too sure about it. Does it cost to post or anything like that? And then I realized it was free to post. So threw it up there. And then after a couple days, a 47 night booking came in and they were coming in on May 10th. So we had like a week and a half to get those renters out of there and then furnish it up for kind of an Airbnb standard. And so we kind of pushed through those 10 days, maxed out our credit cards, buying new furniture, new kitchenware, all that sort of stuff. And then, first guests came in May 10th. They were there till I think it was June 3rd or something, the 47 nights brought them to. And then while they were in there, a family booked for 21 nights starting June 4th. So there was like a 1 day turnaround and then they came in and that was kind of the thing that started it all. And then on June 7th, I think we incorporated a business.
And did they agree to the $500 a night for that long of a stay?
Yeah, because I was new to the platform, so I didn't know that they had like discounts for different lengths of stays. The only thing I had done is when you post it, they tell you, or Airbnb like recommends that you do a 20% off discount for the first 3 customers to kind of get people in the door and get reviews. And so I think they got 20% off the total price.
Okay. So is it a thing where when someone books your Airbnb, they will try and negotiate price a lot, or is it more so they'll just book and accept? Like, can you even negotiate price? Or
yeah, absolutely. I think any sale is up for negotiation. With Airbnb, you have like a wide variety of people. We've had people like all of our properties have an instant book feature. Mm-hmm. And so we've had people instantly book 3 months all at once without even talking to us. But then we've also had people try to book a 2 or 3 night stay that negotiate the rate down and everything in between that. And so a lot of times people will just instant book it for the rate it's at. A lot of times people will reach out and just say, oh, hey, you know, this is my budget. Is this something you can do? Or, oh, hey, it's last minute. Could you, you know, lower it down to this price? And it's kind of a case by case, you know, depending on the type of person, their intent, what we think they're trying to do with the property, all affects in terms of how we're going to deal with that sale. But just like any sale in the world, I think it's up for negotiation. And if you have the right case for it, and or the stay makes sense, then we might, you know, bring that price down to meet their budget, depending on a lot of things, right? If a family's trying to book a 6-month stay, they're displaced with insurance because their house flooded, and their insurance budget is, you know, six.
am, or you can send me a quick text message at 705-344-5690. Thanks for listening to the podcast, and I will see you back next week.